official newspaper files of the early West record many stories of famous and notorious characters of that period. Nevada's most notorious highwayman was a miner from Missouri named Milton A. Sharp, captured after a series of stagecoach robberies and sentenced to 20 years in the state prison at Carson City. He escaped in August of 1889 to continue his interrupted life of crime.
How about a lift?
Sure, jump in.
Drop your gun, guard. You're covered.
From this end, too.
Do as you're told or you're dead. Never mind the strong box. All right, folks, outside. Come on, come on. What's your name?
Why, I fail to see why I should...
Are you Hiram Penrose, the Silver City banker?
Well, yes.
You're the man I'm looking for. Inside, folks.
Now, look here. I'll miss my train. I'm doing Reno to take the eastbound express for Omaha.
Some other time, Grandpa. All right, take him away. You tell the boys in Reno if they want to see the old man alive, not to come looking for us. Take it away. Grandpa. Just move the dynamite and guns. Make yourself comfortable.
And don't give us trouble. You won't get tied and gagged.
Would you mind telling me what you intend doing with me?
You'll find out.
Get in.
Eastbound, I guess.
He's not just trying to make a train. There's something wrong.
Wait a minute, Jonesy. Let's not go sticking our nose in other people's business. We've got that eastbound to catch, too, remember? Come on.
Happy to meet you.
Same to you.
Wait till you hear what happened. You know old Mr. Penrose, the banker over in Silver City?
No, never heard of him. Eastbound Express on time?
It's running about 10 minutes late. But if you've a mind to catch it, you better forget it right now.
Oh?
Yeah. Old Mr. Penrose is a very important man. The Southwest Railroad owns that stage line, and we're responsible for the safety of our passengers.
Well, I agree with you, Billy. Just take Donnie's statement and turn it over to our lawyers. They handle all accidents.
This is no accident, Matt. Old Mr. Penrose is gone. Stolen off the stage. That's what's so terrible.
Oh, say, by the way, have you met Miss Jones? She also represents the Southwest Railroad.
How do you do, Miss Jones?
Hello, Billy.
All right now, Billy. Let's have it all over again, slowly and without excitement.
Hiram Penrose, the banker, was stolen off the stage. Why?
Right now, I wouldn't know.
Well, you better get on it right away, Matt. And be careful. The guard told me his life was threatened if a fuss is made.
Have you wired the law in Silver City?
Not yet.
All right. Wire them and tell them we'll be there as soon as possible. And take care of our bags till we get back, will you? Let's go, Jody.
After talking with the driver and guard of the stagecoach, Jones and I hurried to Silver City by an overland trail through the mountains. We found a man named Dean in charge of the marshal's office at Silver City and began to exchange what few facts we had to go on.
Have a chair, Miss Jones.
Thank you.
You sure got here in a hurry there, Clark.
Well, Miss Jones and I just finished a case in Reno and headed back toward Kansas City.
But I figure if the railroad's involved in this case, we better stick around. Have you got any theories about this job, Marshal?
No, I haven't. Why they took the old man off of the stage is beyond me.
The shotgun guard described one as tall and heavy, the other small and lean. That's about all we found out.
I understand Penrose has a wife here in town. Did you talk to her?
Not personally, but she's been told.
Jonesy, why don't you run over there and keep her company? See what you can find out. If Penrose has had any trouble lately, any threats, any enemies, you know the routine.
Yes, I know. Business as usual with a lump in the throat. Matt, you give me the nicest assignments.
That's a good girl, Jonesy. Next time, I'll let you ride after Robert and shoot the guns.
Oh, I'll bet.
Marshal, why don't you and I ride out to the scene of the holdup? The least we can do is try to cut a trail.
Oh, that's a good idea. We'll pick up my deputy and I'll get you fresh mount.
Fine. The only trail that looked promising was that of a wagon. We followed it the rest of the afternoon.
Sheriff, Grandpa, it can't be as bad as all that.
The dynamite and these guns, I'm not used to them. What are they for?
Stole Rick from my mine. Dynamite came free of charge. Might come in handier than the guns, though, in case you get stubborn. What's the matter?
Three men come up the drawer.
Look like the law?
Can't tell.
Get in the wagon, Grandpa. Lie down, take a nap.
Come on.
All right, hurry up. You stick your head up just once and I'll blow it off. I reckon there's anyone getting on to us so fast. Yeah. Might not be the law. We can't take a chance. Let's go.
Come on.
Just before sundown, we arrived at the place where the wagon had stopped. The fire was still smoldering, and we felt sure the kidnappers were not more than 15 or 20 minutes ahead of us. We caught sight of the wagon in the high country not far from Silver City. When the driver saw us and whipped up the horses, we were sure we had found the kidnappers.
Get this rig and get some saddle horses.
How you doing?
All right.
Not a blast, huh?
Yeah, what was it?
Take care of this man, Marshal. I'll see if I can round up the horses.
Marshal Dean summoned the state militia and sent them out to the place where we had last seen the kidnappers. were instructed to search the country from that point on as far as Reno.
Hi, Marshal.
Hi, Clark.
How's the deputy?
Oh, he'll make it. Say, I'm a little shut-eye. Soon be sunup.
I've just been reading in your weekly newspaper here that a couple of characters escaped from the Carson City pen about 5 weeks ago.
Yeah, Milt Sharp and Dutch Charlie. They sent me a bulletin on it.
Do you remember the description the guard gave us of the two men that took Penrose off the stage?
Yeah, what about it?
These could be the same two men.
Well, a lot of men answer those descriptions.
Yeah, I know. What were these two in for?
Well, Dutch Charlie for murder and Milt Sharp for stagecoach robbery.
Stagecoach robbery? Well, those men that took Penrose off the stage certainly weren't amateurs. I'll see your file on Milt Sharp.
Milton A. Sharp, sentenced to 20 years state prison, result of conviction of stagecoach robbery wherein he held a passenger for ransom.
Ransom? And Penrose is the richest man in town.
Sharp could be up to his old tricks and holding Penrose for ransom.
You know, Marshal, I think we've got something here.
In that case, they'll be trying to make contact with Penrose's wife.
I've arranged to have Jonesy spend the night at the Penrose house. If they do, she'll contact us. In the meantime, do you think you could raise enough men to post guard on all the roads?
I suppose so. It's a bad hour for it, though.
Yeah, I know, but I think we ought to know who's coming in and out of town.
Well, let's get a set up.
Clearing quiet out front.
Come on, Grandpa. Open up for business. Well, he's just stalling for time. You can't tell me he don't know that combination.
Opening a safe is my cashier's job. I'm not used to it.
It's almost daylight out. You cut the time too fine. It's running out on us.
I'm going to give you just 10 seconds to settle down and open that vault, Penrose. Cat gives me the willies.
Shut up! Let her alone. If you don't want her around, I'll put her out. But you don't have to be mean to her.
I'll put her out. Just stay at the vault.
Come on, get out!
Well, there you are for whatever good it'll do.
You go first, Dutch. Fill your pockets. But don't take anything larger than $100 bills. We don't want to be traced.
I shouldn't have done it. I should have had the courage to refuse.
You'd have been too dead to be proud.
Well, I'm probably as good as dead anyway.
You know, I've been thinking about that, Grandpa. You see, I know all about you, Mr. Penrose. All about your pretty little house over on Baker Street. And your charming wife.
Well, you wouldn't harm her.
There's a lot of things I'd do to keep from going back to prison. Come on, Dutch.
Now, see how much you can carry out. I may have to go back for seconds.
Marshal, I've been thinking. Maybe we weren't so wise in posting that guard out on the road. If the gang can't make a ransom contact, they're just as apt to kill the old man and get out of the state.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, something bothering you?
Yeah, matter of fact, there is. That cat that was down front of the bank.
Cat? What of it?
Well, that's old man Penrose's pet cat, and he usually locks it in the bank all night. This is the first time I saw it out before the bank opened. Oh, well.
Hey, wait a minute, wait a minute. Let's go down and take a look in the bank.
Let's go.
What do we do with him?
Lock him in the vault.
No, I'll smother it, Jack.
Get in there.
Penrose, you've been up all night. Why don't you go in and try to get some sleep?
Oh, I can't. It's no use, Miss Jones.
Well, that must be one of the deputies with a message from Matt.
Oh! What is it?
Check that room, Dutch.
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, ladies. We need a hideout for a little while. Anybody there?
No.
You must be the men who took away Mr. Penrose. Where have you got him?
In the bank vault.
Well, you'll smother in there.
Don't worry about him, lady. He's got a couple of hours yet. Now, you two be real quiet till we get out of town. How about fixing us some breakfast and packing us a lunch?
Why, you get nothing out of me. Why, the idea.
Take the blonde into the kitchen, Dutch. She'll fix it.
Oh, no, I won't. And you won't dare pull that trigger or the whole town will be in here.
The whole town will hear me crack a couple of female skulls, will they?
Why, well, you know, I often wondered what it would be like to meet a real outlaw. And do you know something?
I'm not half as afraid as I thought I'd be.
They're all alike, Mrs. Penrose. Strutting little rats, scared to death, you might think they're not tough.
Sit down.
I prefer to stand.
Dutch.
Yeah.
Fix us some breakfast.
Yeah.
Who are you?
No friend of yours.
If I had a little time, maybe I could show you how friendly I can be.
There wouldn't be that much time in a lifetime.
Checking with the men posted around town, we soon learned that nobody had ridden in or out. That meant the bandits were still somewhere in town and we'd have to flush them out. I want to check with Jonesy. I'll meet you at the office.
All right.
Patient. He'll be knocking in a second, and you can ask him yourself.
One scream of false move out of either you, and you both get it. Cancel the door.
What do you want?
Say, what's eating you anyway?
Well, everybody's still asleep, and whatever it is, we don't want any.
Never mind the funny act, sister. Invite the man in. Come on in, mister, or I might have to shoot the pretty lady. I wouldn't if I were you. A lot of bullets will be flying around and the wrong people may get hurt.
Shall I take his gun for...
Just stay where you are. Get his gun, Dutch. Over there.
Milt Sharp and Dutch Charlie, am I right?
You read the papers. Who are you?
Oh, just somebody who's going to be missed in another few minutes.
They know you came here.
That's right, and you'll never get out of town alive. Why don't you get smart before you kill somebody and face a hanging?
I'd rather hang than go back to the pen.
I don't know why you busted out in the first place. Another 6 months, you'd have been up for parole. You just don't make sense.
I don't. Another 6 months, I'd have been up for parole. I'd have been a free man. Then what? Would you have given me a job? Would you have helped me?
What have you got now? You'll never make it, Sharp. They'll give you 10 long years.
It's a colored woman.
That's Sarah, my maid.
You gonna let her in?
I've got to. She'll know something's wrong.
Sorry, sir. Wrong house.
This is the right house, Sarah. Come on in.
I don't like to talk to people with guns in their hands.
Get in here.
Not till you point that gun someplace else. What's going on here, Miss Penrose?
Well, obviously, Sarah, we are being held captive by these men.
Well, maybe you is, but I ain't.
Well, come on down, Sharp. These gunshots will bring the whole town in.
For me.
We've had to pull up, Mr. Penrose.
I'm still trying to catch the train for Omaha. I'm 3 days late already.
Come on in, Mr. Penrose. Always got room for one more. You don't mind, do you?
No, I found Mr. Penrose pretty good company. Move over, Dutch.
Take her away, Professor.
In October 1889, Milt Sharp and Dutch Charlie were returned to the Nevada State Prison at Carson City. This proved to be Milt Sharp's last fling. Nothing of criminal interest was ever heard of him again.